Okay, in the previous class, we have discussed various cloud computing services and also various deployment models. What are the various services provided by cloud? Okay, it is infrastructure as a service, software as a service, and platform as a service. And what are the various deployment models? So we have studied what is public cloud, private cloud, hybrid cloud, and community cloud. So today, we will see the next concept, that is business and IT perspective. Okay, how this cloud computing is being used in various business organizations and how the organization can view this cloud computing perspective means what are the various views of the organization on this. So we know that there are many popular organizations. So some of them are Google, Facebook, and Twitter, Netflix. All those are the organizations which we use cloud computing. And all these organizations have become success after using this cloud computing services. And hence, due to their success, some of the small companies, even they are thinking to opt for cloud, and they are also thinking to make the similar services, whatever the services that these companies are providing to their clients, even the small scale companies are also thinking of similar services to provide to their employees or to their clients. And all the companies, all the organizations will deliver IT-enabled services to their end users, through internet. So I told you the one best example for cloud computing is Gmail. So in case of Gmail, we only use the services. Okay, we only use the services that are provided by Gmail. We will not worry how this actually, Gmail actually works, how the messages will get transferred in the background. All those things we are not going to worry about. And this self-service is one of the important characteristics of a cloud computing. As here you can see ATM. Okay, in case of bank ATM, okay, all the services will be done by the customer itself. Okay, that is a self-service. And also when you book a ticket in IRCTC, okay, in that case also, all the services are self-services. Okay. Now, in cloud provides the various computing resources. What are the computing resources? Means hardware, again, software, network, services, or whatever the computing resources that the cloud is providing, all those resources are no longer confined within the enterprise, which means we can actually use all these computing resources outside the enterprise as well. So how means through the concept of virtualization, all these services can be used outside the organization. How? Through the concept of virtualization. Now, here this cloud computing can be compared with electricity. So when the service provider, in case of electricity, the service provider will be the electricity company. In case of electricity, it is electricity company. In case of cloud, it is a cloud vendor. And the pricing method in case of electricity, depending upon the readings of the meter, the user will pay the electricity bills. And in case of cloud, depending upon the storage used, the consumer has to pay to the cloud provider. And the delivery channel, in case of electricity, that delivery channel is power grid. In case of cloud computing, the delivery channel is internet and access device. Okay, we can actually access the electricity in our houses by using lights, switch lights, fans, and also TV. And again, in case of cloud, the cloud can be accessed through laptops or mobile phones. Okay, and the type of service that is provided by the electric company, it is electricity. And the type of service that is provided by the cloud provider will be cloud file storage or servers or networks. So,
mm-hmm.
Again, in case of this business and IT perspective, this cloud computing provides number of benefits. This cloud computing provides number of benefits or number of profits to an organization, and it also assists the organization in many levels. So what are the various reasons this cloud computing is being used by many organizations? Is one is operational benefits, and another one is economic benefits, and another one is staffing benefits. Okay, we will see one by one. Okay, what is operational benefits means? Okay, whatever the applications and storage that is being used in the organization, after opting to the cloud, all these applications and storage will be moved towards the cloud, and the benefits are reduced cost. Why the cost is reduced means, since we don't have to maintain servers, we don't have to maintain software, everything will be maintained by the cloud provider itself. And in the cloud, there is a huge amount of storage, automation, all the softwares will be auto updated. Again, flexibility. Okay, this is one of the main characteristics of a cloud. Again, what are the various economic benefits to the organization? So the various benefits are hardware. Suppose, say, if we want to do any project, we need some hardware. Okay, say we need around 20 GB of hardware. So if we are using cloud, initially what we do, we purchase around 10 GB of hardware. And when that entire 10 GB is completely filled, in that case, we go for another 10 GB. Again, we have to pay for the services as we use. Again, time all the products, okay? The company can actually deliver all the products in a timely way to the market. Again, wiser investment. Okay, we can invest wisely. Again, security. Cloud is providing a lot of security. Okay, there are a lot. Actually, the cloud providers are investing a huge amounts to provide security. Again, reduced capital expenses. Okay, we can actually reduce the capital expenses in the organization. And also, we can meet the short-term goals. And staffing benefits. What are the various benefits that are staffing benefits means? So how this cloud will actually help the staffs that are present in an organization? The staff, they don't have to install a software. They don't have to maintain the software. And a developer can actually deploy the application or upload the application very quickly. So since cloud is providing its own platform, the developer can actually quickly deploy the whatever the applications that are being built by the developer, everything can be quickly deployed in the cloud. Again, upgrades. All the softwares are auto upgraded. So, and the next concept, is virtualization. I told you, right? Virtualization is one of the main concept in the cloud. What is this virtualization means? What is the meaning of virtualization? So virtualization, the meaning is which is not real, okay? Logical one. We actually create a virtual version of something such as server, desktop, storage device, or operating system. We can actually virtualize all the computing resources that are available in the cloud. So, in case of virtualization, what we do means a single physical instance of a resource. Say we have a server. Okay, that one server can actually be shared among multiple consumers, multiple customers, and multiple organizations. How it can be done? So, for a physical server, or a physical machine, we are going to actually assign some logical name. through that logical name, and that logical name will be given to the organization or to the multiple customers, and by using that logical name we can actually access the physical storage. So here, in case of virtualization, there are three main components. So here we have three layers. In the bottom we have a physical layer, in the bottom. This is the bottom layer, which consists of hardware, physical hardware, physical storage, and physical networks. So now we have a virtualization layer. So we can actually virtualize this hardware. Okay, we can actually virtualize this hardware. Okay, that is virtual hardware. Again, virtualize this physical storage, virtual storage. Again, virtualize this physical network, that is virtual network. Okay, this virtualization can be done by using a special software, that is software emulation. Okay, the example for this software emulation is VMware. Okay, software emulation. This software emulation is actually used to create a virtual version of all the physical devices or all the computing devices or computing resources. And we have a guest. So here, once we have created all these virtual versions of all the physical instances, all these can be accessed by a special machine, that is virtual machine. Okay, that is virtual machine. Here we have three components, yes, right? Guest, host, and virtualization layer. What is guest means? It is a software component. Okay, this guest, it is a software component which will interact with the virtualization layer. What is host means? Okay, host, it represents a machine on which a guest machine is built. Okay, there are various types of virtualization. Say there is operating system virtualization, desktop virtualization, server virtualization, storage virtualization, and many things. Okay, say in case of operating system virtualization, what we do in one operating system, say here I am using a Windows operating system. So within this Windows operating system, by using a virtual machine, I can actually install another operating system. Okay, within a one operating system, we can install multiple operating system. Why do we do? Means to see the way performance of different operating system and also the interoperability of different operating system. So virtualization. So again, we have virtualization layer. What is virtualization layer? Means recreating the, we actually recreate the physical instance. Physical instance of this hardware, recreate the physical instance of this storage. Okay, again, recreating the network, physical instance of network will be recreated as virtual network. So here in this example, this is one computer. So here, see, in this computer, we have actually installed two operating system. And both the operating systems can be used at the same time. Okay. Both the operating system can be used at the same time. See, a traditional architecture. In the traditional architecture, we have the physical storage. This is the physical storage. On top of physical storage, there is an operating system. Again, by using that operating system, various applications we can execute various applications. And in case of virtual architecture, by using the same physical storage, we will actually use a software emulation, that is VMware. By using this VMware software, we can install multiple operating system in the same physical. Okay, and the concept, this virtualization concept is being used in past 30 years. See, virtualization, if you are using computers, you have already done a partitions for your hard disk, yes, right? That is also a concept. That is also one of the example for virtualization. One entire hard disk, we are partitioning into various logical partitions. Again, here it is written, yes, right? Virtualization, it is the foundation for all that is possible through cloud. Okay, why this cloud is so popular means because of this virtualization. We have only one physical existence. That physical existence, we are creating it as a virtual version by using some softwares. And all those, and that, and we are actually providing access to this virtualized instance. Again, the benefits of virtualization is scalability, again automation, and we are using a standardized services. So that is all about virtualization. So you will study this virtualization concept in detail in fourth unit. Okay, there are some various architecture, okay, machine architectures are there for this virtualization. Again, dynamic cloud infrastructure. Okay, dynamic cloud infrastructure. This is also one of the service that is being provided by the cloud. Okay, usually the consumers, cloud consumers, their services, whatever, sometimes what they do, they will suddenly ask for a new application. They will suddenly ask for a new service. Okay, dynamic cloud infrastructure means the cloud will actually provide the infrastructure in a dynamic way. Okay, but depending on the changing needs of the user or the consumers, all the cloud infrastructure will be provided to the cloud consumers. Again, this dynamic cloud infrastructure will consist of the following things, that is service management, asset management, virtualization and consolidation, information infrastructure, and elasticity. Here it is written. Okay, cloud and dynamic infrastructure. What is this service management? Okay, this is one of the facility. This is one of the facility that is being provided by the cloud provider to the various business and IT firms, which involves whatever the service that a cloud provider is providing. Okay, there is a visibility, which involves visibility, automation, and everything will be controlled or managed by the cloud. The same thing here I have written, asset management. So the cloud provider, okay, there are various services. All these services, we also say it as assets. So what are the various services? Means platform, again server, again services, hardware. All these are the assets or the properties that is being provided to the consumers. Okay, and all these assets are managed to a very greater extent so that all the asset values are maximizing. Again, virtualization. Okay, I told you with the use of this virtualization, all the resources are used efficiently. Say there is one server that is being virtualized. That since that one server is shared among multiple organizations, that server is used 100%. Okay, that server is used 100%, which means through virtualization, all the resources are utilized effectively. And also through virtualization, all the company's operating costs are going down. Again, information infrastructure, whatever the information that is provided by the provider, it ensures information compliance, availability, again retention. Okay, all our data is stored continuously. Okay, and whenever, and it can be retained. Okay, say there is a natural disaster, during that time also, since our data is stored in the cloud, we can actually retrieve all those data. So energy efficiency. So in case of cloud, there is a lot of servers. Okay, there is a lot of servers that are present in the data center, and all the servers should be always up and running. So for that, the lot of power has to be supplied. When we supply the lot of power, all these servers will actually consume lot of power. And also they will release carbon dioxide. To use the energy efficiently, we will use a concept called green cloud. Okay, to use all the energy efficiently, we will use a concept called green cloud. Again, In case of security, we will manage the risks. See, security will involve a lot of risks. Okay, all those risks will be managed by the cloud provider. And also we have to customize the governance. Here, risk management refers to the risks involved in the services. So there is a lot of risks involved in the services that are being provided by the provider. And customization of governance. All the features that are provided by the cloud, all those things can be changed. Okay, and that all those things can be customized as per our requirement. Okay, that customization will actually depend on the provider's wish. Again, resilience. What is the meaning of resilience? Means, okay, even when there is a fault in the network or in the infrastructure, everything will work. Okay. So this infrastructure provides the feature of resilience, means the services are resilient. It means the infrastructure, okay, the infrastructure is safe from all sides. Okay, the IT operations will not easily be get affected.